Y'all, we're the Squirrel Nuts, Zipper.
And you're watching 120 Minutes on MTV.
Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield here right now with Scotty, Kurt, and Glenn from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. Good to have you guys here.
Thanks for having us.
Really cool to finally have you on the show. Let's talk a bit about the fact that, I mean, you know, people talk about the success of swing and swing-influenced music right now and being back, but you guys have been doing it for a few years now.
Yeah, we started in 91.
91, right?
Yeah.
When was that when you started your own label thing?
We started our own label. We started to record for our first record in 93. We released it in 94 and just basically wanted to do it really grassroots. So we just hung, didn't do any distribution, and sold it out of the back of our van and just basically went out on the road and just did this thing when there wasn't a thing.
Right, exactly. Now, you ended up hooking up with John, of course, who's a friend of yours, with Swingers. Tell me about how all that came about, because you were a big part of that.
We've been playing at the Derby every Wednesday night, I would say, for about 3 years.
It has been, right?
And at the very beginning, I mean, John would come out every Wednesday night, you know, and everybody pretty much in the movie were all friends, and it was the Wednesday night hang, you know, and ended up.
John came to me one day and just said, hey, I've got this script, you know, would you guys be interested in doing it? And I was like, yeah, you know, I'll read it, and I'll get back to you next Wednesday. I threw it in the front seat of my car, and the week went on, and I didn't read it because I was going to do it anyway because John was such a great guy. And then when he came back, he goes, did you read my script? I go, ah, man, it was the best script, man. We'll do it for sure. And then like 3 weeks later, we're actually filming this thing at the Derby. And they basically just went into the Derby and just filmed a night at the Derby.
Really documenting what really goes on and the whole vibe.
What it was like. There. At that time, that was a great piece of what it was like.
That's
big
excellent.
Time.
Yeah. Really, and it's really, you know, it's had such an influence on the scene all over the country. You know what I mean? Since that film has come out.
Yeah.
We've got lots more to talk about with the band. Of course, the guys here from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. But right now, we're going to check out 120 Minutes debut from the Squirrel Nut Zippers from their forthcoming album, Perennial Favorites. Hit stores on August 4th. And they're a great band as
well.
Get
it, kids. They're a great band.
Check them out. This is called Suits Are Picking Up the Bill. Brand new on 120 Minutes tonight.
Excuse me. Can I still be served?
Yeah. Hey, it's Matt Pimple here. I'm hanging out right now with Scotty, Kurt, and Glenn from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. Now, let's talk a bit about how you guys came up with the name. Now, it had to do with an Albert Collins concert that you went to, actually.
Actually, when I was about 17 or 18, I went to go see Albert Collins in a little club in Santa Monica, California. And he just blew the place down. I mean, he's this just huge, menacing guy, and he's just a stinging blues player. And me and my friends were in the front row just like screaming, Voodoo Daddy, Voodoo Daddy, because he just looks like a big, huge Voodoo Daddy. And at the end of the night, I ripped the poster off the wall, and I said, you know, Mr. Collins, will you sign my poster for me? You know, this is a wide-eyed kid, really, you know, blown away by the show. And he wrote to Scotty, the Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. And I was like, that's amazing. So when me and Kurt were putting the band together, we were like, you know, what do you want to call it? And I said, we got to call it Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. And his eyes like lit up. And he just goes, that's the name, man.
That's very cool. Yeah. Now, has Albert Collins been a big influence? I mean, there's been some great stuff out, like that double collector City Liberty put out.
Yeah, he, among others, have been a really huge influence. And that's why the name is so great, because it just represents our American music influence.
Yeah,
I mean, and the night too, you know, like that night for me specifically was like such an energy blowing night that, you know, that's sort of what we try to do every night of the week. I mean, it doesn't matter if it's a Monday night in, you know, Saskatchewan, we're going to play just like it's a Friday night at Roseland, you know.
Yeah, and no matter how many people are there, you're just going to put the energy out.
Every time, that's how he was, you know, that's how the legends, how they all sort of worked him, and they gave it their all because it's just about music.
Yeah, it's about enjoying playing too, and it's because you really love doing it as opposed to people that go, well, there's not enough of a crowd, I'm going to be half-assed.
Yeah, you get half my show tonight, man. There is no half of a Big Bad Voodoo Daddy show.
That's the cool thing, and it's, you guys have a reputation for it, which is great. Cool. We'll be talking more with the guys from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy in just a bit. Until then, check out the top 10 singles around America this week. Welcome back to 120 Minutes. I'm Matt Pinfield, hanging out with Scotty, Kurt, and Glenn from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. Now, guys, one of the really cool things about the recording of your latest record, which is called Big Bad Voodoo Daddy, by the way, on Coolsville, which I love the name of the label, too, was done, you recorded that thing at Capitol Records of the legendary Studio B in the tower there. I mean, that must have been really cool to be there.
Yeah, it was a dream come true. I mean, we and Glenn were just talking about is just drive it in there. You know, we live in Los Angeles, and it's a monument. The Capitol building is a monument. Yeah. You see it every day, and it's like, that's the pinnacle of dream come true. And every day to drive your car through the gate of Capitol, knowing you're going down into Studio B, where Sinatra, Nat King Cole, Nelson Riddle, I mean, all the biggest, best things ever recorded in, as far as this music is concerned, was done there. To do it, it was amazing.
It's like the first time you pull up there, you're like, and you see the gate opening up for your car, you're like, oh my God, they're gonna let me in this building finally.
Yeah, right.
And you get to go in there and record in this studio, you know, that Nat King Cole's been in, and you're just, it's just amazing experience.
Was the Sinatra death something that affected you guys in a personal way? I mean, were you big fans of not only his records, but, you know, things like his movies like Meet Danny Wilson, Pal Joey, those records are just cool, you know, timepieces.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, Sinatra, I mean, anybody who listens to music, I mean, especially as a musician, bar none, I mean, you listen to all that early Sinatra stuff, and I mean, his phrasing is beyond belief. I mean, he was such an innovator of what he did. And it was a great loss. It was very sad.
Yeah, do you have favorite albums by him, like Songs for Swingin' Lovers or Swingin' Sessions?
The Swingin' Sessions for me is the one. I mean, we've been burning that thing out in our bus like crazy.
Yeah. Swingin' Sessions is cool.
And movies, amazing. Too, of course. Manchurian Candidate is one of my favorite movies.
That's a great film.
He's amazing.
Man. Absolutely. And From Here to Eternity, I mean, just brilliant stuff.
Yeah.
But you've been influenced by everything from that to Black Flag, even.
Absolutely,
Which just has to do, again, with the energy in the live show.
Yeah, I mean, I remember when I was like 15 years old, I saw Henry Rollins playing with Black Flag the first time, and I just said to myself that that's what I want to do, you know, and then just like following someone like his career, you know, you watch it and the integrity that he brought to the music and to what he does as an artist and a performer is something that's like what we're influenced by people's attitudes such as like Tom Waits and people like that.
Very cool.
Just for like what they represent as far as musicianship and things of that nature. And that's the sort of influences that we bring to the 40s style of swing that we play, but we don't feel like we live in the 40s or we want to be in the 40s or we're born in another time. And we like being right here, right now.
Right in the 90s.
Yeah.
Exactly, but you put that 90s twist on it.
Absolutely.
That makes it modern. Right now, let's check out your video from your self-titled album. This is You and Me and the Bottle Makes Three, right here tonight on 120 Minutes. We'll be right back.
gin and juice I'm drinking.
Hey, Scotty.
Yeah.
What's it gotta be?
A gin and tonic sounds mighty, mighty good to me. Man, I know I gotta go. It's the same thing every time. But I don't think another drink's gonna make me lose my mind. So I think about my next drink. And it's you and me and the bottle next three tonight. Yeah. Well, I know this cat named Mo. He wanders to and fro. Isn't my favorite water and hole. How you doing? Where have you been? He says, I've been fine with my whiskey, wine, and gin. Man, I know I gotta go. It's the same thing every time. But I don't think another drink's gonna make me lose my mind. So I think about my next drink. And it's you and me and the bottle makes three tonight. Come on, Dad, let's drink up.
Welcome back to 120 Minutes. Matt Pinfield here, hanging out with Scotty, Kurt, and Glenn from Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. Let's talk about the guys who produced your record.
Brad Benedict and Michael Frondelli.
Right.
Brad Benedict is from the Ultra Lounge series, the guy who created that and just the mastermind and just, in our opinion, super genius.
Right.
Michael Frondelli, wonderful producer, engineer, mixer, did the record. We met those guys about 2 years ago. We were going to do another record on our own, just independent. We had no like thoughts of going with anybody else. And when we met them, it just changed our mind completely. They won us over, and it's a great marriage right now.
That's great. And you'd already had the Ultra Lounge series of CDs and stuff that had
come
out.
Yeah, it was a huge, when Brad called me up and he said, yeah, I'm Brad from the Ultra Lounge, and we talked a little bit. I'm like, wow, the Ultra Lounge, that was like so clever. I was thinking that was, the way he packaged it and put it together.
Yeah, it looks
super genius.
That's excellent. So you'll work with him again probably on the next record as well?
We're going to work with Brad as long as he'll work with us.
Now, you guys have had so many requests to do everything from Super Bowls to private parties. I mean, you know, just people are such big fans. And with all that, those requests, plus touring, is it going to give you any time to do an album anytime soon?
We're working on stuff on the road. That's the one thing that we've always done. And we've always been on the road, too. That's one thing that Big Bad Voodoo Daddy has always done is since 94, we've been out. So what we do is we're just in a pattern. When we write a song, we work it out, a sound check, and then we just throw it out to the wolves and play and see what happens and then get those things so worked out that when we come back in September for a few days, we'll go and record 4 or 5 new songs for the record.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that's the way it was done in the old days. People would spend just too much time worrying about writing sometimes. In the old days, you toured all the time, so you would write on the road, and then
you'd
break in the new songs live.
And those are great records. That's how great records come out, because they're still live records. People are playing these songs live, and you work them out, and they've got the energy. It's not like a packaged product. It's a live energy.
And we get an immediate response also from the audience. We just played a new song the other night for the first time. they went nuts for it, just yeah, like every other song.
Right, so then you get a barometer of how it's going to work out.
Absolutely,
you.
Yeah.
Whether it's worth putting on the album or what you have to do with
this
it.
Worked. This worked.
This didn't work.
To make it rave up worked. A little more.
We didn't hear any crickets this time, so that's what they were.
Like that old Buddy Holly story, right? I got that. Guys, I want to thank you for coming down.
Before we go, Matt, we're going to make you an official member of Big Bad Voodoo Daddy. We're going to give you the official fedora, my friend.
Rules, man.
Welcome to the band.
Thank you so much. Good to be a part of it, guys.
You got it, man.
Thank you so much. This is awesome. This is excellent.
Look at how cool he looks, man.
Thanks a lot, guys. Does this work all right?
You're looking good, man.
Thanks for coming down. It was so cool to have you guys here.
Thank you, man.
People should definitely check you out on tour. And check out Big Bad Voodoo Daddy's self-titled major label debut, as well as a Christmas album, What You Want for Christmas. You can also find them on the soundtrack to, of course, Swingers. Also look for them all summer on tour. Now, right now, with the latest video from the Foo Fighters, from X-Files, the album, it's Walking After You. Guys, thanks again for coming by.
Thanks, Matt.
I'm honored, man.
Cool, man.
It's very cool.